Well, hello and welcome back to Arena Zagreb. We are ready to start the women's foil team round of eight. Only eight teams in the tableau today. And we will have Hungary facing Poland, Russia facing Ukraine, France against Germany, and you can watch the green pieces and yellow piece in isolation. We're going to blue. Italy will face Romania. And that very strong Italian side. Di Francesca, the individual champion, is her song and dance routine. The team salute there. Di Francesca, Durando, Erba, and Arrigo on for Italy. For Romania, Ballo, Boldor, Caligarianu, and Stan. And Erba will start. Caligarianu on for Romania. Italy, the number one seed, Romania number eight. Russia, the number two seed, facing number seven, Ukraine. Number three seed, France, facing number six, Germany. And number four, Poland, facing number five, Hungary. Looks like Ballo, Boldor, and Caligarianu will start for Romania with Stan in as reserve. Not a clear indication yet who the reserve is for Italy.
I'm guessing it's Arianna Arrigo. And I'm basing that purely on the fact that Di Francesca and Durando are both holding their weapons at the moment, but that remains to be seen. There's a earthing light coming up on the repeater boxes, which is why we've got this delay at the moment. We're just having a look at the action on the red piste. As we now flick across to the blue, the Russians and Ukrainians were tied up at four apiece there in that first fight. Korobeynikova on for Russia, and Moskovska on for Ukraine.
Well, we're ready to go here. First of nine legs, Erba, Italy, Caligarianu, Romania, and we are underway.
Goes through from Erba, but it's off target. Target area and foil is everything apart from the arms, legs and head. Mekepe, the referee, is looking for the attacking fencer, and in that case it was Erba, so she strikes first. First to five in the first match. So relay of nine legs. Target score multiples of five based on the leg you're in. And preparation from Garianu. Erba scores a second hit. On the red piece, the Russians won the first leg 5-4.
They are in the second on the green piece. France leading Germany 6-1. And Hungary in the second, leading Poland 4-2.
Another attack from Erba, and it's no real surprise that the Italians are already three hits up on the Romanians. Another attack from the Italian, this time off target. Erba seems to be starting her attacks from some distance. Slightly shorter than Garianu. Picking up the blade. The Romanian fails to hit with the riposte, and continuation goes through from Erba, so it's 4-0 now. Post from the Italian fails this time. But the Romanian is not able to land, so it still stays 4-0 halfway through the first leg. Tied up there, referee calls halt. There's a counter riposte and a commanding lead already for the Italians, as we now know that Arrigo is going to be fencing. She comes on for the Italian team, and she will face up against Boldor. Target score of 10 hits in this second leg. Meanwhile, on the red piece, it's still tied up between Russia and Ukraine, 7 apiece. Dereglotsova on for Russia, Chintsova on for Ukraine. It's 9-2 to France over Germany, with Thibaut on for France and Vakta on for the German team. And Hungary and Poland still in the second, and Hungary are 6-2 up.
Schedule for today is a tight one. We started at 1 o'clock. The men's EPE semifinals are scheduled for 2 o'clock, so 50 minutes from now, as Arrigo gets her second. And then at 2:30, 14:30, two of the women's foil semifinals are scheduled to begin on the green and yellow pistes. Men's épée semifinals on red and blue, and then two of those semifinals will occur for women's foil in the preliminaries hall. And then at 4 p.m., 1600 Central European time, we'll have the third place match for both events occur simultaneously in this hall. And then our final matches begin at 17:30.
Well, that's the schedule for today, and the schedule for right now is Errigo has taken the Italians into a 10-2 lead, as we can now confirm that the individual champion, Elisa Di Francesca, is having a rest. She's the reserve for the Italian team. And if things continue like this, she'll have a rest until the next round. So Durando comes on. It's Paolo. Italians 10-2 up. Yakovleva is on for Russia on the red piste against Lileko of Ukraine, and the Russians have just opened up a small lead, 10-7 going into the third on the red piste. Yeah, start of the attack was quite slow from Durando, but she continued through, drew the counter-attack. She said that she stopped halfway through and it was a simultaneous action. No, the score has just gone up and it was given to the Italian. Fails with a flick over the back. Romania are up to three hits. Simultaneous. No hit given there. Hungary have gone 8-2 up over Poland on the yellow piste. In the third period there. Third period on the green piste with France 12-2 up over the Germans. Nice fast start for the French team. Durando. There's a problem with her weapon, so surrenders it to the referee. She goes to change that. Bernadetta Durando will go and retrieve a backup weapon. These fencers will have a number of weapons in their bag, all weighted and set identically. Test goes on. The weapon has to carry a certain amount of weight. And that's relative to the amount of force that needs to be applied to make the tip of the sword go in. It's like a little plunger at the end of the weapon. Those of you who are new to fencing. That was parried by the Italian, but she failed to land her riposte. The Romanians score their fourth. 11-4 down. Referee's going to have a look at this one. And gives the attack to the Romanians. Andrea Chipresa standing up, shrugging his shoulders, and a review is called. has not overturned that decision. So Romania are now 5-11 down. French team have gone 15-5 up against Germany on the green piste. Looks like the Romanians are going to call for a review here. As they do, the coach stands up. We'll have a look at that one. Stands 14-5. And that's 15-5 now. So Erba of Italy versus Boldor of Romania. Fourth leg after the 9-leg relay. This is the quarter-final stage of the women's team foil at the 2013 European Championships. Brought to you on the FIE live stream from Zagreb, Croatia. Getting a little bit too close that time. Barrier pass. 2-0 up in this leg. And the Italians are just extending their lead at the moment. The Russians are 15-9 up against Ukraine on the red piste. And the Germans are rallying. Vactor has closed up against Guillard, France, on the green piste. It's 15-9 to the French team there. And the Hungarians are 12-2 up against Poland on the yellow piste, and they're in the third leg. Parapost fails, counter-repost is off target. deflections off target from Baldor. But the Italians have opened up a commanding lead already.
See that on the yellow piece, Hungary now with a commanding 14-2 lead coming to the end of the third period. These all seem to be one-sided affairs here, with Russia up 18-9 over Ukraine, 18-9 France leading Germany, 14-2 Hungary leading Poland, and here 20-5 the score.
Yeah, Germany closed up a little bit from that. They were a bit further behind. Still nine hits down, and the French team looking strong. The Russians started slowly against the Ukrainians, but have found their form, and Korobeynikova has just scored their 19th hit. They're now 10 hits up, 19-9 against Ukraine, as Durando comes on for Italy against Caragiano of Romania.
Well, Caligariano scoreless in her first outing. Baldor scoreless there, and it's difficult to get any kind of traction, especially against a team like Italy, and you don't score any points. To start or continue the fifth leg of nine. Just remind you that you can select the yellow and green pieces at your leisure at the top of your viewing screen. Video review there, and that is an attack given off target. Referee in this leg, Javier Lorenzo of Spain, of Madrid to be precise. And Durando, her first point in this fifth leg, target 25. Referee Lorenzo, I believe, is a journalist when he's not traveling the world.
Yep.
Refereeing fencing competitions. Gariano unable to find the target. And now two for Durando. He's scoreless in her first outing, but at this point managing 2 points against Durando.
Another one for Durando.
Welcome all of our viewers to this day three broadcast of the Senior European Fencing Championships from Zagreb, Croatia. Arena Zagreb. We've got three more days of action to follow and plenty more here today. To remind you that if you're not following us on Twitter, you should be. We're at FIE underscore EN and on Facebook at FIE International Fencing Federation. And also important to note that if you don't have our smartphone app available for Apple and Android systems, you should download that. Durando, her fifth, closes the fifth. 25-8 the score. Caligariano did manage three in that outing, but not enough to make a dent. And Mariana Arrigo will be on in the sixth, facing Rita Ballo.
Yeah, the other piece still, as you mentioned earlier, on one side of the affairs, Mitrogen on for France against Golubitsky of Germany, 24-11 up in the fifth. Target score of 25 there. Russia 22-12 up against Ukraine, also in the fifth. Just to round things off there in the fourth on the yellow piece, Hungary 17-5 up against Poland. And here we go into the sixth. Here we go against Ballo. The Italians, they're a long way ahead here.
Well, there's a big drop between the top half and the bottom half of this tableau in terms of rankings. 1, 2, 3. So the only big surprise we have here, Hungary, Poland ranked fourth. Poland ranked fourth, Hungary fifth. But Hungary leading 17-5 in the fourth. That's pretty much domination in the other two. Number two seed Russia leading 23-12 over number seven seed Ukraine. And number three seed France leading 25-11 starting the sixth against number six seed Germany. We have yet to see our new European champion, 2013 women's foil individual, Elisa Di Francesca. Presuming that Italy goes on to defeat Romania, they will face the winner of Hungary-Poland. And another on that attack from Arrigo, needing two to close this sixth leg. Target there. Rigo trying to hold the line there, but that attack given Bello. Bello off target on that attack. Attack Bello. 4 points for her in this outing. And with that parry, riposte, Arrigo reaches 5, Italy to 30. And despite a game outing by Rica Bello, 4 points for her. We will go to the seventh leg with Italy leading 30 to 12.
Pretty unsurprising, really. Hungarians looking likely to be the Italians' next challengers. They're 19-7 up on the yellow piece.
Caligariano with nil points in the opening leg. 2 points for Boldor, 3 for Bello, and then nil points for Boldor in her second outing, and you can't do that and stay in this match.
No, but I do have to ask whether you watched the Eurovision Song Contest a couple of weekends ago.
Did I?
No point.
Used to be a big fan. I think I did watch part of that. That attack, Durando. Now, Boldor asking for a review there. And the call stands. So, one apiece for Boldor and Durando. Attack Durando. Referee indicating that Durando's attack failed. Boldor picking up the right of way and scoring. So in this seventh leg, no net gain for either side. Durando scoring successfully on that attack. attack, Boldor. .140 remaining in this seventh leg. Benedetta Durando needing 2 points to close. But a fourth there for Maria Boldor. And there we have it. Durando with her fifth, 4 points for Boldor. 2-8, and DeFrancesca will make her first appearance. A bit of a warm-up for her for the semifinal match. She will face Rica Ballo.
Well, like you say, she's probably just having a little warm-up for the next round. There's a delay on the yellow piece, so the winners of Hungary and Poland, which at the moment is looking very much like it would be Hungary, will face, almost certainly face the Italian team, but the whole Polish fencer is currently lying down on the piece.
That is Lyspinska of Poland. She's on against Napek of Hungary. And the physio's attending to her left leg, it would appear. Francesca with the first point in this eighth and penultimate leg. Target is 40. And one apiece for DeFrancesca and Ballo. DeFrancesca off target there. That attack fails. Ballo counters. And her second in this period. Long attack there, off target. And again, off target.
It always amazes me with DeFrancesca, even though she's so tall and sits down so deeply, people seem to get fooled at a lunge. There you go. Well, that's what I'm saying.
Like that?
She can just snap out a perfectly timed and well-executed lunge. Keeps things so simple, very elegant fencer.
And very disciplined.
But it amazes me, you know, with again, lovely attack with a block out there to make sure she didn't get a light against her. But people seem to get fooled by the length of her attack over and over again.
And that must be why over and over again she's on the podium collecting medals. DeFrancesca needing one. To end the eighth, and there we have it.
David, over on the yellow piece, Lyspinska is still down on the piece, and I'm not 100% sure. I don't want to say that the match has been abandoned just yet, but it does look like the Hungarian team are. Maybe the substitution. It's been made because of the injury. You just see that over the back of the piece there. But anyway.
Slavinska, Lyspinska, Sinaradska, and Wojkowiak are form the Polish squad.
It's hard to know what's going on, but we'll keep an eye on it.
The physician that's attending to Sinaradska is in between our camera position and the athlete, and so difficult to see what's going on there. We don't really have a clear shot at that.
Anyway, Rigo here to close things off for the Italians. Starts well.
Overpost there.
Three away from sealing this one off.
I believe that I just said Sinaradska. It is Lisbinska that is on the floor there.
So Italian starts her attack. She brings her arm back, and Talia Guarani gets her first hit. It's challenged. Javier Lorenzo goes over to his colleague to have a look at that.
Well, Lisbinska is up. Her ankle has been taped. They are in the fifth there. Hungary leading 20-9. Here, Arrigo needing 2 points to end this match. Gariani with her third. Pardon me, second. It would appear that the match has been abandoned on the yellow piece.
Well, I can only imagine then that the substitution had been made prior to that injury happening.
Well, that ends it here as well. 45-21, our final score, as Italy will go on to face Hungary. Hungary advancing in the fifth with an abandonment of the match after an injury to Lisbinka, Hanna Lisbinka of Poland. We'll find out what